Sample number 20 is our knife pleat sample. You're going to cut a piece of muslin from your pattern and it's cut on the fold. You have a lot of notches here. You're going to clip all of the notches. The whole purpose of making the pleats is that you're adding this extra fullness. You'd see these mostly in skirts. I'm going to show you how to do this, and it's primarily using your iron to iron these pleats in. So here's my whole piece with my notches. I've marked my notches with a black marker just so that you can see it easier. We're creating the knife pleats, so they're all going in one direction. I'm going to come over to my first notch, and my notches are at the top and at the bottom. I'm going to take these notches, I'm going to skip one, and I'm going to fold it to the next so that my fold is actually the middle notch. And I'm going to press that nice crisp fold. That's your first pleat. I'm going to go over to my next notch and I'm going to fold it, skipping one notch, going to the next, and again lining it up with the bottom so it's straight, and I'm going to press that in. You want these to be hard pressed. When you buy something at a store, they send it out to have it pleated so that it's permanently pleated. For our purposes, this is perfect. Again, I'm going to come to my next set of notches next to the pleat that I just created. I am going to fold them over, skipping my next set, and going over to the following. And you're going to do that right across until your whole piece is pleated. So now I have my piece with all my pleats pressed in. They're pretty crisp pleats, so they're not going to come out. For the purpose of our sample, we don't want to leave our edges raw. So I'm going to overlock my edge on the both outer edges and across the bottom. When I overlock the bottom, I want to pull this out and I want to overlock through as an open pleat, not when it's closed, because if I overlock when it's closed, then my pleat can't move. So when you overlock your edges, you'll be able to pull your pleats open. So outer edges and the bottom. Now I have my overlocked edge. You'll see my black markings showing, but again, that's just so that you'll understand. You won't have any markings like that. Now I'm going to turn my sample over so I have a clean folded edge over here, and my sample begins on this side here. I'm going to turn it. This is the top of my sample. And so I'm going to pin across these pleats through all layers because we're going to stitch them down. So go ahead, pin each pleat down. Now I'm ready to stitch my pleats in place. I'm going to start at my edge with a half an inch seam allowance, and I'm going to use a permanent stitch. You can lock it at both ends. And I'm going to stitch right across through all layers, making sure to take those pins out right before I get to the stitch so that I don't break my needle. So now you can see that they're secure. The pleats are secure at the top, but they move at the bottom where you need that extra movement. My last step will be to overlock this top edge through all layers with pleats in place so that it doesn't fray. This is what your final sample should look like. Give it another hard press so that those pleats are crisp, and you are finished.